So Matt, could you tell us just a little bit about the wrist that you've developed here?
Okay, Pat, it's a multi-position wrist that you can go in thousands of different positions. On each axis, there's five different positions,
Okay.
which, so I five times five, and you're 36 different positions here, and 24 different positions here.
Okay, so if you multiply it all
Yeah,
together, it's what's like
you're getting
18,000?
close to 18,000 different
That's just
positions.
crazy. I think the key thing too, could you just mention a little bit about it's not just it doesn't just move, but it actually locks in all of those positions
Yes,
too.
it's a locking wrist, 25 and 50 degrees in both ways.
And do you find that
And then you got rotation.
there you go. Do you find that's important to have it locking for the work that you're doing?
Yes, with wrenches and stuff, it's needed.
And then could you explain too, because you've got the two different axes here. Most wrists have one axis that they will flex in, but not two. Can you
Correct.
talk a little bit about why you decided to have two axes?
That is a key factor also. It's when you just have a standard, flexion one way, and then a fixed tool. When you go to rotate, that tool will rotate with the holder unit, and you lose your angle. Which the great feature of this wrist is it rotates on both ends. So when you get to a position and your wrench or your terminal device is not at the right angle, you can go ahead and turn that to whatever angle you want. That's where you get all the extra positions with rotation on both ends.
Now describe a little bit of the work that you're doing and the kind of the atmosphere that you're working in.
I work in a rock quarry, which is very dusty, dirty, heavy equipment, heavy machinery, lots of maintenance, and I needed to come up with something that will withstand the rigorous everyday maintenance.
And then talk a little bit about too the material that you chose. This is not that heavy. I mean, I'm looking at this wrist and I'm thinking, wow, there's a lot of mass here, but it's really not that heavy. Can you
Correct.
describe the metal you chose for that?
The metal is made from 7075 aluminum, which is the strongest grade of aluminum that's available for machining. They come with different disconnects, twist, push button. I mean, they're custom.
Describe also the tool insert that you've designed to work with this.
Yes, the actual tool holder, which can accept any kind of tool, utensil. The sky is endless of what we can make to go in these, but they're a two-piece holder, which with what they'll be interchangeable with whatever style disconnect that you can use, just by changing the disconnect bushing.
So if you damage the tool, the point is you don't have to buy everything all again. You
Correct.
literally just replace the tool
Replace the tool.
and it's modular that way.
Yes.
That's a great idea.
Anything you can think of that you would like to be able to put in into an arm, that's what I make. That's what I do. From wrenches to utensils to an archery bow, a fishing rod. We customize the equipment per individual. It's not just a catalog, this is all we have. No, it's what do you need, and we'll try to make exactly what works best for you.